So today I was looking up some information as I was preparing for a coaching client, and I came across this hadith, which you probably have heard before. And it says that Allah is beauty, or God is beauty, and He loves beauty. But here is the rest of the hadith that often is not quoted. And it says that Allah loves loftiness in affairs, and He despises pettiness. Now, the scholars interpret that as meaning when we set goals in life and want to achieve things, then we are instructed to reach for the highest and the best of that achievement. We shouldn't set mediocre goals, that Muslims shouldn't seek to be average or achieve the minimum or only achieve the low-hanging fruit. We should actually go for the highest goal that we can set. And the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he actually reiterated this and in fact said, "Do not ask Allah for Jannah. Ask Him for Jannah til Firdaws." Because if you are asking for Jannah, then you miss it. Where does that leave you? But if you ask for the highest form of Jannah, Jannah til Firdaws, and you miss it, you still have six levels that you can fall into. So it is the Islamic version of reach for the moon, and even if you miss, you'll be among the stars. This is what the Muslims are instructed and encouraged to go for. Go for the lofty goals. Go for something that is audacious. So as I am helping my client set clarity for what she wants to achieve in 2019, this is what we are considering. What do we want to achieve that is audacious, that can really be the best of the best, the ideal of the vision, so that we're not trying to just be average? Why be average? That's easy. Be of the 1%, be of those who achieve the best and who strive for the best. So, go for your 2019 audacious goals.